Blasphemy is a highly sensitive issue in deeply conservative Pakistan, where mere allegations have led to extrajudicial killings and mob violence. Human rights campaigners have long sought the repeal of blasphemy laws, arguing they are used to victimize religious minorities or settle personal scores. However, Pakistan has turned blind eye to this discriminatory law. We have a report.
These are the visuals of a mob of enraged Muslims staging a protest outside the civil hospital in Faisalabad district of Pakistan. Members of the crowd were demanding that the two Christian nurses of the hospital Maryam Lal and Nevish Uruj be arrested and hanged for committing blasphemy. Muslim colleagues accused the two women of committing blasphemy by removing a sticker that had a Quranic text written on it. Beheading is the only punishment for blasphemer. These were the words of protesters gathered in the emergency department of hospital, and one of them even kicked Maryam Lal as she entered a police van. Moreover, a ward boy in the hospital also confessed to wounding her in a knife attack. Somehow, both the nurses were rescued by policemen. In Pakistan, such false accusations of blasphemy are widespread and often motivated by personal vendettas or religious hatred. Pakistan's religiously discriminatory legislation has contributed to horrible human rights abuses, creating an atmosphere of intolerance for religious minorities that often leads to violence and discrimination. Accusations are highly inflammatory and have the potential to spark mob lynchings, vigilante murders, and mass protests.
As you can see that recently two nurses were targeted in Pakistan and mob, they attacked hospital and they claimed that these nurses have committed blasphemy. Now, these are normally personal vendetta cases where Muslims target non-Muslims, and these nurses are now facing blasphemy cases against them in court of law, and they are behind the bars, and nobody can save the victims of blasphemy law in Pakistan. This is the situation where, for example, if I am a Muslim and I am working in a company and there is a non-Muslim whom I don't like, I can go to police station and I can say that he has done sin by speaking against Prophet Muhammad or Quran. And I don't need any witnesses or anything. My testimony is enough to implicate anyone in Pakistan.
Since Pakistan added Section 295B and 295C to the country's controversial blasphemy laws in 1987, the number of blasphemy accusations have skyrocketed. In February 2021, Center for Social Justice, an NGO based out of Lahore, released data that showed the abuse of blasphemy laws had increased exponentially in Pakistan. According to this advocacy group CSJ, from 1987 to December 2020, at least 1,855 persons have been alleged under the offenses related to religion under Pakistan blasphemy laws. One of the most high-profile cases drawing global attention has been that of Asia Bibi, who was handed the death penalty on charges of blasphemy in 2010 and imprisoned until November 2018, when the Supreme Court acquitted her. But not everyone is fortunate. At least 20 people convicted of blasphemy remain on death row in Pakistan. Although no judicial execution for blasphemy has ever occurred in Pakistan, the threat of violence and murder by non-state actors looms large. The Center for Social Justice in its report has claimed that at least 75 people have been killed so far in the country on the accusation of blasphemy. Quite frequently, bloodthirsty religious fanatics or radical groups go on killing sprees inside and outside the courtroom, targeting the accused, their families and lawyers, or anyone who may have expressed support for them.
Once you are implicated in reckoning law of blasphemy, then nobody can get justice. Even police people, administration, justice, they cannot change it. If someone, a policeman or a judge, tries to give verdict in favor of the victim of blasphemy, their families are targeted and their lives become in danger. In Pakistan, Governor Punjab Salman Taseer was killed for speaking for Asia Bibi, a victim of blasphemy law. And sitting Governor Punjab was killed in broad daylight in Islamabad by his own guard. And we could not find a Maulvi to perform his final prayers. And that Maulvi that performed his prayers had to flee the country. So this is the situation of blasphemy law in Pakistan.
Pakistan's blasphemy laws violate the rights to life, freedom of thought, conscience and religion or belief, and also freedom of opinion and expression. Although non-Muslims make up only 4% of Pakistan's population, about 50% of the blasphemy cases in the country have been reported against them. Love and affection of the Holy Prophet is such a precious asset that Pakistanis are willing to torture and kill for it, and nothing indicates that they will stop anytime soon.